Researchers in the Triad are yet again making leaps and bounds in advancing modern medicine. WXII 12 Joshua Davis is in downtown Winston-Salem with an inside look at how a $48 million grant could impact your care in the future.
It's like something out of science fiction, using technology to simulate the human body to develop treatments for exposure to damaging chemicals.
Dr. Anthony Atala of the Wake Forest Institute for Regenerative Medicine says when it comes to modern medicine, 90% of drugs that enter clinical trials in humans fail to enter full production because of problems researchers fail to detect. But research into a body-on-a-chip technology may change that statistic.
Which is basically a miniature collection of tissues and organs that we can use as surrogates to test drugs. We have developed a number of organs, including lungs, skin, hearts, brains.
This program, which is being funded through a $48 million contract between Wake Forest and the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, will be mostly focused on chemical damage to human lungs and skin.
Can test the toxicity, whether it's good for the patient, whether it's bad for the patient, and look at the benefits.
But they also plan to examine the effects of various diseases.
This program is looking at fibrosis, which is scar. But in reality, scar is present with every disease, whether you have diabetes, heart disease, lung disease. At the end of the day, it ends up in scar. So this program is looking at how to detect that scar, how to prevent it, and how to treat it.
Congresswoman Kathy Manning, who attended Thursday's announcement, says this project can and will have a positive impact in multiple fields.
It will help not only members of the military, but other people who have exposure to toxic chemicals.
And the contract also stems from a partnership between Wake Forest and the Biomedical Advanced Research and Development Authority, building on previous research of chlorine gas exposure. In Winston-Salem, I'm Joshua Davis for WXII 12 News.